Yeah, if you have a dumb capital town, Benko Kumasi to Bekoti Congress. come back to me. Kai will trim with seven, why you be pain? Oh, school girl, come back to me.
Oh my God. See, there's just something about throwback songs that, you know what, just gives you or puts you in a good mood.
Yes.
These songs are timeless. And I mean, just listening to them is bringing back memories. As Nanaya said, we reminisce on Thursdays and it's all a good feeling. And we've been having this conversation since Monday. We are analyzing throwback songs since the 2000s. What went wrong? What were they doing right back then? How things have evolved and all that. And the same guest, they are already seated here again, Adam, the surname. Chotome. He's an entertainment journalist, and Yao Yebwedu Ayebwafo is also a music executive. They are the right people to have this conversation with, and they've been with us through it all. So yes, today we are having them again. Yao, I mean, Tuesday you weren't here, right? Yes. So with Adam, we were talking about how back then they had music executives. And that is what another reason that their songs were thriving back then. It was doing so well. And how they were not able to pick it up when we entered into the digital age. But before we do that, I mean, Adam gave us his top three. We give the list for today, 2005 to 2006. So let me give it to you again. Chiobodom featuring Chiobodom in Kase, Fefenefe, Tick, and Tony Tatula. Toffee, that is by Castro. Otolege by Oforan Ponsam. Old School by Lucky Mensa. Metiasi, that is Nobun Kitia. Emanuela Oforan Ponsam. I Want to See You, My Father, that is Kina Isoba. Kwabna Kwabna Aso, and then Kwekujesi. Onyamia Seda. Onyamia Seda. Yes, that song. So, which are your top three if you're going to choose from them?
So, my number one would definitely Otolege.
Of course.
By Oforan Ponsam. Mm-hmm. The second would be Taken, Tony Tetwila, Fefelemfe. Then the last one would be Kina Isoba.
I Want to See You, My Father.
Yeah.
I'm surprised. You really like that song, right?
That song, you see, that song was easy to sing along to.
Yeah. Yesterday. But you know, it's just recently that I realized that we were singing it wrong.
Yeah.
Some of the lyrics in there were singing. It looked like it was simple, but we were singing it very, very, very wrong.
It was an emotional song.
It was due to the tonation.
I tell you.
Checking up.
But, I mean, since you're here, I want your take on where we ended about music executives. I mean, Adam said that they were not able to transition from the music as in producing and supporting the artists to digitally monetizing the music streams. What was your whole thoughts on that?
Yeah, I agree to that assertion. I think the transition from the CD era to the streaming era was not as streamlined as the cassette to CD era. I think most of the producers back then they couldn't foresee the future that the internet had, especially in Ghana.
Mm-hmm.
And what sometimes I don't blame them, because you look at what is working and in your mind you're like, oh, it will never fade. People are used to it, without realizing that there's a new generation that's going to come and have a mind of its own. So I agree with that assertion. They failed to properly transition. In fact, many they didn't transition at all. A lot of them did not transition at all, leading to even losing some of the songs that we had. Because even if you go to streaming platforms, not every song
that's
a classic that you are going to even find there.
Yeah.
Even some of the artists till now do not even know that people are actually streaming their songs and making money off their backs. So that was a major setback, because we got late to the party.
Yeah, I agree. You remember Moses Okeh was here?
Yeah.
And as in last year, he didn't have his songs on any of the streaming platforms. He didn't know anything about it. He didn't know how to go about it. He was confused.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I
understand what you say, but how was it that from cassette to CD was swept?
It was physical.
Okay, physical.
Yeah. It was physical.
You know, the mechanical.
You can hold it. You can, because you know, most of this executive producer actually has stores.
Yeah.
They have physical stores where they sell their wares.
Despite music show.
Yeah.
But
you know, in between there too, we sort of had this whole pen drive thing coming along.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm trying to understand why the cassette CD Swift pen drive was a bit, but to the digital media, it was a bit of a problem.
Some were thinking it was magic.
But let's be honest. I don't know if it's a musical thing or Gumroad thing at that time. who was supposed to aid or lead it. Yeah. But you know, when there's a transition or something is about to happen, we see how people are advertising the new telecommunication. Yeah. It's not like new, but they are changing the name and the whole noise mm-hmm. about it. Is it that someone was supposed to work on that, organize summit, conferences, have workshops, mm-hmm. and then make them understand that this is what it looks like will happen in the next couple of years?
Those who were exposed, mm-hmm. there was a few of them.
Okay.
Those who were exposed hit it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And it was like, there are some people who were the go-to people if you even want to upload your song on YouTube.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And up to now, there are some artists who have problems with them because they feel those people didn't tell them like, there was a certain revenue, like the streaming revenue. Mm-hmm. All they did was they uploaded for them.
Mm-hmm.
It was a few who knew, and it was like a certain tool for them. So mm-hmm. they kept those knowledge, and it wasn't open.
That's
and
bad.
That is one of the challenges, you know.
Yeah, I wanted to ask, but if we are slow as an industry to catch things up.
We are not that slow, but this industry, this really happened. When people get exposed to something,
mm-hmm.
they keep the secret. There was this lady. he was a music executive in US. I've forgotten the name. She died.
Mm-hmm.
She's of Ghanaian descent.
Lillian Blankson.
Yes. Mm-hmm. When she died, some of the artists started thanking them her for opening doors for them in US and other things.
Mm-hmm.
And some people said, "Hey." So this has been happening. You guys, I mean, one person who was attacked for that was Kwakese. Like,
mm-hmm.
it was like, hey, so like,
you before knew, yeah.
You we don't know it. Of anybody like that, you know. So like, it's one thing in the industry. Like, because also at times when you are getting help from somewhere,
mm-hmm.
and you introduce somebody there, he comes to destroy you.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? Oh. Just to take a point. That thing. They go on. So I think it was why the people who knew at the time. I mean, there were a couple of them, Ibrahim Ohinijan mm-hmm. knew, Panji Ano.
Yeah.
I mean, they were those who knew more about this than other people, you know. And it's like we were not able to have that mass.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, especially those who were pushing the money into.
Yeah.
I mean, they didn't get to. And if somebody doesn't understand a space, it is difficult for them to invest.
Yeah.
So. Most of them look at other alternatives, you understand, to ensure certain things were mm-hmm. working for them. It's even happened to the issue of the movie.
Mm-hmm.
When that thing also happened, where the era of decoders.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I went to Kumasi to do a full documentary on that. And I went to most of the big stores who were themselves producers and having shops. The big names. I went there one-on-one to their shops to interview them. Most of them tend to sell in those decoders, which came to destroy the industry. The satellite and decoders. People were selling mobile phones. Some of them have big shops. They converted mobile phone accessories.
Mm-hmm.
Most of them, if you go to KJTR.
Mm-hmm.
And I asked them, and they were like, when the switch came, people were looking at the streaming, how to take advantage of the streaming platforms and they, as businessmen, they said they were not ready for that because they realized that set lightning call for top buffer for. So any phone, mobile phone and accessories. So they decided to, as business people, they want to get returns.
Yeah.
So they quickly stopped producing the movies and got into that. And they said that is what has sustained them to today. So the business people, if they do not understand what is happening, they will not invest. And I think we needed a lot of, education. In that space, and music as a welfare body.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, because this will go into welfare. At the end of the day, if money is not coming, the person's life is deteriorated.
And that's what I wanted to hear.
Those who are top leaders of the industry could have taken advantage of that to ensure the industry is at the same pace mm-hmm. with the world mm-hmm. so that people will have confidence in investing. I mean, it is why we didn't get... It's like, you're giant, you know. Let it happen.
Yao has a lot to say. Yao, let's hear from you.
Oh, no. You're listening
and then making your points in your head.
I actually have a lot to say, but I think you made a valid point when you were asking whether our industry is slow.
Catching up.
Yeah, I wouldn't say our industry. I'll say the nation as a whole is slow when it comes to technology, infrastructure. Yeah. We have countries doing 5G. Mm-hmm. We are still on 4G. Some are even upgrading. 3G. Some are even upgrading now to 4G.
Yeah.
Do you get it?
Some are still on 3G.
Yeah. And also, until recently, the likes of Spotify, which is like the biggest streaming platform, was not even available in Ghana.
Mm-hmm.
You get it. So all these, we as a nation do not have, I don't know how to term it, but we don't have a mindset when it comes to, let's say, our lawmakers,
mm-hmm.
when it comes to technological infrastructures and decision making,
it's
usually neglected in the background, especially our parliamentarians who are there to actually set the laws for us. They think about the tangibles than the intangibles. you get me?
Yeah.
Because how can a Ghanaian have their songs on Spotify and it takes until recently to have Spotify setting? Like being available in a country like Ghana. You see, it sets us behind many years. But if we are able to have these organizations talk to them, like the way the US government and the UK governments are able to talk to them and have them.
Yeah,
they bring available. You to parliament to explain some of it. Senate, to explain some of it.
Can't blame the government. Because you know what? I saw Mark Zuckerberg posted his picture today on Facebook, and I was reading some of the comments, and one person said that he's not happy with the way Mark has limited we making money off our content, but then is constantly pushing content for us to, I mean, look at the ads that when you go through Facebook, you're constantly seeing ads. Mm-hmm. So if you're constantly pushing ads for us, where you have limited us from making money from our content, then you should not be pushing these
ads.
So what stopped Parliament from calling faith? To come and explain for people, bring people in the space who understand.
Yeah.
Try to probe further. Mm-hmm. Because at the end of the day, when things happen well, it will go to the benefit of your citizens.
Yeah.
You know, so some of these is like, oh, money happening, it's happening. Mm. We just allow things to chance. And it's affecting.
We are very slow.
When it's election time,
like this year.
There's the technology to count votes.
Yes.
There's a strong room.
Mm. Yeah, oh yeah.
Yeah. As and when it comes. But when it's not election year, the technology is out of the door.
It's unfortunate. See, this conversation is getting interesting, but we are opening the phone lines so that you. Colleen, please, as Nanaya said, list your songs down.
Yes.
Don't let us pick the call before you now try to remember. you just write them down. If it's 3, 4, we'll listen to you. And please lower the volume of your set. You can even turn it off and then talk to us on the phone. You'll be putting the numbers on your screen soon. But let's talk about trends, though. Because, Adam, you mentioned something that, I mean, when we see something new, even with the movie industry, We are quick to change. What are some of the trends that, you know, back in the day, the industry players or the artists saw, and then they quickly changed to different trends, and that affected how we listen to or how we make songs now?
Oh, for me, I think the only thing which at a point created a little challenge for us was the time where Nigerian music started invading this territory. I mean, it made the whole industry so, like, we became so, like, what's that? Like, you want to do something. So what happened was that
so fixated. That's
we were looking to other alternatives. And at the end of the day, we ended up leaving our own. That is where hip life started having problems.
Yeah.
It started like...
Killing the game.
So when Killing the Game or Chame Kwame came, it's like people didn't pay too much attention. They thought maybe he just wanted to throw shit. But they were moving to a certain... Because they realized that they needed something to grip the space. And they didn't pay too much attention to what we're doing. And it got to a time some people were even trying to, do much like the Nigerians are doing, because they've realized that that strain of music will be able to compete with them.
Yeah,
as okay. It was the thing at parties, everything.
Hold that thought. There's a caller. Hello, good afternoon. Your name and where you're calling us from?
My name is Tom Begum. I'm calling from Medina.
Nana, can you hear? Can you please speak
up? Yeah, we can't really hear you.
Yes, please speak up.
My name is Togbe Ghana.
Togbe Ghana, okay.
Yeah, a musician actually, calling you from Medina.
Medina, okay.
Yeah. So give us your hit songs.
Abiwaha. Yeah, we can give it to Kinayusuba as well. I want to see my father.
Okay. That's it.
Yeah.
All right.
Wow.
That's it.
Basically, my thoughts, about the music industry.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, you can see it's getting so worse. We don't have no industry as of now. We've been in this game for the past years now. Nothing is really working.
Oh.
Just from streaming to performance and from making some money as well, it's not working. I guess we don't have an industry. And also, at the same time, talking about pundits, we don't have people that are really educated into the industry that can come in to actually educate the youth and have a change, basically. You know what I mean? The pundits, we see people on a YouTube, we see people on other TV stations that are just talking trash into the microphone, because it takes a lot to produce music,
and
also it takes a lot to be creative.
Calm down, say.
So when we see people trying to underrate our creativity, it's so appalling. You know what I mean? Actually, it makes us feel like you guys don't know what's up, basically. To say my thoughts again, I think in music streaming in our country is becoming a big problem because a lot of people don't understand what is that. We have to educate people about it.
Yeah.
Believe me, the first education I'm giving people here is that when you play a Ghanaian music, you are putting money in your brother's or your sister's pocket, basically. Yeah. So how we are promoting the other people's country music on our TV stations, on our radio stations, and all that, it doesn't make sense. Because the more we try to play our people music, our own friends, or if you don't even know me, if you play my music, or if the people that even you know, we try to generate what we call it social economy. We try to project that. You know what I mean? Because it's so sad that the Ghanaians don't understand this technology. When you go on TikTok right now, you try to dance to other people's music that are not even Ghanaians. We have to project our culture, our movement, our people. We should know that we don't have a place to go apart from this country. Yeah, I'm the Let's Go Clean the Beach campaign.
Okay, all right.
And I'm trying to help people to go clean the beach and all that. I would love to invite you guys on,
Thank you very much.
Go and clean the beach, Usu Beach, on the 6th April. You know what I mean?
All right. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Wow. That's deep.
I like it when
that's
people
deep.
Are passionate like
that's
this.
Deep. Oh,
like,
no, it's very good. But, Adam, from what you were saying, something came into mind. You see, even though they wanted to switch, the question is, what were the people enjoying, which was hip life?
Yeah.
So why did they see it that it is important to just make a swift shift into a genre that a country was doing for its people?
What they were, you see, it got to a point. Those songs coming from Nigeria, they didn't have, they didn't have that, the hip life thing.
Yes.
It was more of singing songs.
Yeah.
And people were loving those vibes. Mm-hmm. When you go to parties, those Nigerians.
In Ghana here, they prefer those ones.
Yes. I mean, when that invasion started, happened. it was massive. It was nice.
Because I'm trying to. Do you remember some of the songs that were really like really penetrating the market? Like, okay,
there's another. The Peace Quest.
But we also went there. Why didn't we invade with the VIP?
Why didn't we invade? That's the question.
But we invaded.
Call it a thriller.
But it was not as massive as you said that for.
You see, there's it's about money.
Yeah.
I told you one thing which helped us invade there was even some of them. Kenny's music.
Mm-hmm.
He partnered with Goody's music in Ghana.
Yeah, Adam, so, please, I'm coming in. Hello, your name and where you're calling us from.
All right, my name is Esenam. I'm calling from Medina.
Medina. Hey, wow. Hey, that's Medina. Two Medina calls. So, that's good. Give us your favorite GH hit song from 2000 to 2006.
So I will go for a song by T Blaze, Flini a Deep. And then I'll go for Obra Force, Girl Big Jimmy, Deba by Deba.
Wow. Oh, that's good. That's good. That's a deep one. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Yes. So let me just share my thoughts on the discussion ongoing.
Yeah.
So first of all, I think that there's no unity within the industry. I hear people say there's no industry. There is an industry. However, the problem is the unity that will help everybody come together to champion a goal. The DJs are also operating separately. Yeah. The so-called gatekeepers are also operating with their favorites. The musicians also think that they can do things on their own. The producers are also doing things on their own. Everybody is just doing things on their own. But this is an ecosystem where one depends on the other, the other depends on that, the other depends on the other. The gatekeepers are expected to go for us outside Ghana, look for the bigger platforms where the Nigerians, like how the Nigerians are also operating, make connections and bring the musicians and producers together for them to also have access to those big platforms. Mm. But the gatekeepers have their favorites. Mm. And so therefore, when they go out there, and they go and even meet the big show. When they even happen to meet the big guys, they want to send their favorites there. Okay. Maybe their favorite is not the person who has the actual capacity to make the correct deals. So they will take. I've heard of a story where there was a musician who happened to meet a recording label, this big time record labels, and then he went with. He didn't go with any of his team members. He went alone.
Oh.
And that particular deal fell off, you know. So we need to have the unity. Once we have the unity, we can do things together.
We can do things. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. You know, this whole conversation about this.
We need like 2 hours, you know.
We need 2 hours for that. But, you know.
So, I mean, our music, like I was saying, our music invading there, they were even part. Kenny's music promoted some of our, they took some of our songs from here, from Goodies Music.
Mm-hmm. And they took it to Nigeria. Mm-hmm.
And a song like Fefe, there was a certain, I don't like, I've been talking about
you,
that.
You, because yeah, yeah, you
there was
go
a certain
break.
Arrangement, okay.
We'll go for
Let's
break.
Go for break.
But we will continue. It's still an entertainment review on Metro Television. We'll be back with more.
I wish we could just make you guys preview to the behind the scenes conversation. Like,
it's so
interesting. Yeah. One of these days, we need to record and then put it on social media. But I waffle. Adam has talked about the trends that he feels that it didn't help us.
Yeah.
What about you?
Well, as Ghanaians, we naturally kind of jump on trends. It's part of our history. we jump on trends.
It's like he's trying to be so diplomatic about the whole thing.
But you see, I think at the time when the entry came, it was because it was a fresh sound, and whenever you have a fresh sound, there's always this hysteria about it. Oh, it was nice. Is that I think what some of our musicians failed to do was to take their time and let it clear from the eyes of the fans. Because anything new, even if we were new, we go to school.
You
are jumpy, but after a few days, it's normal.
Yeah.
But then they also decided to also jump on the bandwagon.
Yeah.
And that led to we sounding Nigerian. That I got to a point where you could not differentiate.
Smooth, some of
you could not differentiate whether this is
Niger
or Ghana.
Yeah.
Also, one thing that led to the saturation was our music executives or labels were now transitioning from music into other form of businesses.
Mm.
Some concentrated on their media business. others concentrated on their goods selling. Others went into the underworld to do whatever they were going to do. Like, everybody took, they left the music into other ventures. Whilst in Nigeria, the Kennesys were being multiplied. There were more labels coming in. You get it. So it meant they were pushing in more music into our market whilst we were pushing less music out. Yes. And that brought about the financing issue where now you have to finance your own music. Because in the past, before your music goes out, you've already taken a bag.
Mm-hmm.
You already have your money.
Mm-hmm.
How they go sell the CD doesn't really concern you. But now, it is now your responsibility to go and do your own CDs and come and sell. And that's an extra burden on the artist. And so all these are like factors that brought about the switch.
Wow.
We didn't have enough investment, direct investment into the music.
Mm.
And I know we want to blame Musica in a way because Musica is an association of musicians, but you can't always blame Musica because at the end of the day, Musica is made up of musicians.
Musicians, yes.
So most of the musicians they forget one thing.
Mm-hmm.
They are ambassadors to their music first, before anybody.
Yeah.
There is no gatekeeping. If, as a musician, you cannot sensitize your fans that have switched from CD to cassette, cassette to CD, it's your fault.
Mm-hmm.
If you cannot sensitize that you switched from cassette to streaming platforms,
it's your fault.
That is your fault. You understand? Because you are, it's your career.
Mm-hmm.
You are the first point of contact, not me. I mean, nobody knows that me. I work with you. So the education was needed from the musician's perspective. But unfortunately, some of the musicians switched.